Hello, I'm Dr. Stephen Castor. I'm the Chief Medical Officer at Menorah Medical Center. Today we're launching our virtual house call seminar series. The goal of the series is to introduce our community to many of the world-class physicians that we have at Menorah Medical Center. Our guest today is Dr. Roger De La Torre. He's a renowned surgeon with bariatric and metabolic specialists located in the Overland Park and Leawood areas. Dr. De La Torre specializes in helping people regain their livelihood and their life through weight loss surgery. He holds more than 60 patents, many of which have helped his bariatric patients. We're here to specifically discuss the relationship between obesity and reflux disease. And additionally, we'll also take questions from the viewers regarding surgical weight loss. So Dr. De La Torre, why is reflux such a problem for the obese population?
Well, simply it's a problem of pressure. Women who've been pregnant know that during their pregnancy, especially in the latter stages, there's a tremendous amount of intra-abdominal pressure that can give them GERD, even if they didn't have this gastroesophageal reflux previously. My wife, for example, had that with our three pregnancies. With the obese population, you have an increase in visceral fat. There is fat infiltration to the liver, and all of that increases the pressure in the abdomen and causes things to want to reflux up towards the esophagus.
Many people hear that reflux is associated with a hiatal hernia. Do those always go together in your experience?
So commonly the two are equated. Reflux is often linked to hiatal hernia, but in fact, you can have a hiatal hernia without reflux, and you can have reflux without a hiatal hernia.
Do all surgeries that treat morbid obesity also treat reflux disease?
No, there are some surgeries, in fact, that although they may help because of the weight loss, we just talked about the amount of fat and pressure inside the abdomen, with weight loss that should get better. But some surgeries, such as the vertical sleeve gastrectomy, which has become very popular, take a football-shaped stomach and then reduce the size and make a tubular-sized stomach, and so the pressure increases. It's kind of like putting your finger on a hose, and then the spray comes out much faster because of the back pressure.
Can you define what morbid obesity is for the audience?
So morbid obesity is a specific medical category, and what physicians often use is the term BMI for body mass index. As you can imagine, it's quite different to have a woman who's 5'1 and weighs 310 pounds and equate that person to a man who's maybe 6'5 and weighs 310 pounds. So with BMI, we take not only weight, but the height in and get a better calculation of someone's fat. So anyone with a BMI greater than 40 is considered morbidly obese.
For those viewers who have reflux and are overweight, what would you suggest be their first step in evaluation or treatment?
The first step with GERD or reflux usually is medical. And simple things like elevating the head of the bed, not eating within the 2 hours before you go to sleep. But if reflux is a problem and you are morbidly obese, then the best operation is one that can treat both. And the gastric bypass has a 90% effectiveness or greater when dealing with reflux disease. And it's easy to imagine. In creating the small pouch stomach during the surgery, we divide that small pouch from the acid-producing larger portion of the stomach. Acid can no longer reflux up into your esophagus and give you the problems of GERD. At the same time, you will lose a lot of that intra-abdominal fat as well as a tremendous amount of fat all over.
Dr. Dellatore, are there any long-term damage to the body that can occur when people have acid reflux disease?
So yes, if you have chronic reflux disease where acid is constantly regurgitating up into your esophagus, number one, it can go up so high that you actually aspirate that. Some people wake up in the middle of the night coughing from the acid that has gone up into their esophagus and down into the trachea or the breathing pipe. The other thing is that if it stays long enough, that acid begins to produce changes in the lower esophagus that can become precancerous, a condition known as Barrett's esophagitis. And cancer of the esophagus, which may result from that, is a very bad cancer to have.
All right, now we'll take some questions from the audience. If you have any questions, please feel free to submit those, and Dr. Dellatore would be happy to answer those questions.
What are the types of surgeries you offer in your practice?
Dr. Dellatore, while we're waiting for the questions to come in, what types of bariatric surgery do you all provide in your practice?
So our practice provides three major operations, which we do commonly. The gastric bypass is probably the one that we still perform more so than the others, but gaining in popularity are the vertical sleeve gastrectomy, and for certain patients, the duodenal switch is one that used to be reserved for the super morbidly obese, the people who used to be done, you know, my 600 pound weight loss, those type of people used to be reserved only for them. And the duodenal switch was done more in Europe before it became popular here. So we do those three, but we also do things such as endoscopic treatment for obesity, where we can alter the stomach endoscopically without the need for surgery. And we also do things like the gastric balloon, where a balloon can be placed inside the stomach and give space and give you the sense of fullness so that you eat less. And during a certain time period, usually 6 months, we can modify how you eat, go through dietetic counseling and things like that.
How quickly can a patient see weight loss after a surgery?
So it depends on the surgery, but if you choose one of the main three, it's not unusual to lose a pound a day immediately after surgery for the first month to 6 weeks.
What are the steps I have to do to get ready for surgery?
So can you define the steps that a patient has to go through to qualify for surgery?
Sure. Of course, you need to see one of the surgeons if you're interested in surgery. And then a lot of people want to know, well, how long after I see the surgeon can I get on the operating room table? Well, a lot of that depends on whether or not you have comorbidities, things such as diabetes, heart disease, things that often are equated, go hand in hand with obesity. So that may take some time to get cleared. You know, go see a cardiologist, have the cardiologist confirm that you're healthy enough to undergo an operation. And then sadly, insurance companies still mandate some of the delay. Many insurance companies will ask for 3 or 6 months of a physician-supervised weight loss before they will consider surgery for the insured.
I'm only about 50 pounds overweight. Do I qualify for surgery?
Next question is, the viewer is only 50 pounds overweight. Would he or she qualify for bariatric surgery?
At 50 pounds, it's unlikely. Someone whose BMI is 40 is usually around 100 pounds over their ideal body weight. If you are less than 100 pounds over your ideal body weight and you have diabetes, high blood pressure, sleep apnea, joint disease, and things like that, then that can push you to an area where you would be considered a candidate.
I'm only in my early 20s. Do I qualify?
So one of the questions from a viewer was he or she is in their early 20s. Do you have any age requirements as far as who qualifies for bariatric surgery?
So yes, we still don't do pediatrics here, but if you are 18 up to, we've done patients in their 70s, then you can still be a candidate for surgery. Being 20 does not prevent you from an operation by any means.
All right. Well, thank you, Delatorre, for meeting with us today. We appreciate all your ideas and comments regarding bariatric surgery. For more information about the weight loss program at Menorah Medical Center, please check out our website at menorahmedicalcenter.com/weightloss, or you can call our bariatric coordinator at 913-498-7367.